It's that time. Let the buddy build begin. Hey guys, how's everybody doing on this Sunday morning? Well, Sunday afternoon? Oh well. Hey, it's that time. Bryan and I are going to be starting our buddy build this week. So, I thought I would give you a look at all the pieces and parts. Although that pieces and parts doesn't sound quite right, because this thing is a beast. I mean, these pieces and parts are like pieces and parts. But I'm looking forward to it. This is going to be a fun build. But real quick, before I flip this camera around and show you those, I got them all spread out here on the bench behind me. I do want to let you know that, unfortunately, there won't be any updates on the MIG. Yeah, that one crashed and burned. I mean, big time. It went from being probably the best paint job I ever did on a model to very quickly becoming, well, let's put it this way, the only thing it's good for is to put it in a crash diorama. I mean, it, part of it was my fault and part of it was the kit. It's just, it was an old Hasegawa mini craft kit. I don't know how old it was, but I know it was old. And there's no UPC on the box anywhere. There's no date on the instructions at all, because I looked for one. But it was just bad. It ended up bad. So, anyways, I had originally thrown it away and just, I crashed it into the circular file. But then Tommy talked some sense into me and said, you know, well, at least keep it for a crash diorama or something. And I said, yeah, you know, that's not a bad idea. I may do that. If it was a smaller scale, I'd crash it into one of the mountains on the train layout. Yeah, but anyways, yeah, that one turned out pretty bad. So, moving on, let me get this camera swung around here. We'll go on wiggly wobbly mode. So, put your seatbelts on. So you take your Dramamine and I'll show you what's next on the bench here. Hold on, I'll be right back. I was chatting with Bryan this morning, who I'm going to be doing this buddy build with over at BG Models. If you're not subbed to Bryan, I will try and leave a link in the description down below to his channel. But I was telling him that mine didn't have any decals, and I was asking him if his kit came with decals. Well, then I found them. They were literally stuck to the top of the box. And when I say stuck, I do mean stuck. So, it's a good thing that I wasn't really planning on using any of these, because I'm not doing the hot rod version to where I would have the flames or anything like that. But yeah, these decals are pretty much toast. So then let's start. Oh, hold on guys, I gotta unplug you here because my cord's not long enough. I hope that didn't mess up the video any. But let's start with the chrome here. And all of my chrome is going to have to be stripped. I mean, it's really, really bad. I had looked at it a long time ago when I first got this kit, but I had only looked at it through the plastic bag. I hadn't actually opened them. And this stuff is bad. I mean, I hope this will show up on the camera so you can see how bad the finish is. But I was showing it to Bryan this morning. I was sending him pictures of it. And his description is very apropos. I mean, if I was building this as a barn find, I wouldn't have to touch it. Because that's exactly what this chrome looks like, is barn find chrome. I mean, it is it's pretty bad. So I'm going to have to strip it. And then, as you can tell, looking at the back of these, it's chromed over red plastic. So it's just going to be more red plastic that I have to paint over. So, but that's okay. We'll do it. But that's all the chrome parts, and I mean the detail on it is actually pretty good. I was impressed with the detail on it. And these are the wheels that I'm going to be using, even though I'm not making the hot rod version. I just love these wheels. So my build is going to be kind of like what my cars were grown up. I am not a mechanic. I know how to change the oil in a car, and that's about it. I know nothing else about cars or how they run, how to fix them, anything like that. But I can put gas in it, and I can change the oil. But my cars are always all show and no go, as they say. So that's what this one's going to be. It's going to be basically stock, but it's going to look good, if that makes sense. So then this is the getting into the red plastic. This is the interior bucket here, obviously. And then we get into the seats and the motor parts, the steering wheels. You got a couple of choices for the steering wheels. Some more motor parts there, and you have the white wall inserts for the tires also. And then you got the front bench seat and the dashboard, which is pretty nice. So we'll be doing some detailing on that, and you even got the fuzzy dice that you can hang over the rear view mirror. So motor halves there, and then there your bucket seats, the front and back halves of those. Then moving into the black molded pieces, we've got the chassis here. And then you got two different hood styles, depending on which motor you plan on using. I'll be using this one here. And your red clear pieces, your horns here, and some more motor pieces, fan belts and pulleys and all that kind of good stuff, shocks. You got your exhaust and your mufflers. You got your battery, which has some nice detail on it. And your leaf springs and front end, rear end, all that good kind of stuff. And then you have the body. And like I said, this is a huge car. And the body is actually in good shape. There are a few rough spots on the hood here, but other than that, it's in pretty good shape. Then you have your choices of tires here, which you have the thin stock tires, and you have a couple of the wider Goodyear Eagle, but your slicks, you're doing the drag, the race style, or just your heftier, which are also Goodyear tires. But they got a nice tread pattern to them. So you got some options there. But that's pretty much it. The clear parts are in that bag right there. And they're actually in pretty good shape. So I left them in the bag just to be on the safe side. So that's what's in the box. And like I said, Bryan and I will be starting this week, so you can look forward to some updates. Alrighty, so we shall see everybody on the next video. Hope you all have a good week. Hope you had a good weekend. And for those of you that are coming to Jacksonville next Saturday, I will see you at JaxCon. I can't wait. Talk to y'all later. Bye.